very sharply here, get out of the blocks quickly after yesterday's results. That's not quite going to do it, is it? Dupin, goal. Dries, out of Moroccan descent, known as the quiet man of the team. Just likes to sit. Well, he go about his business. Had a decent game yesterday for Spain, one of the few bright spots for them. Lorenc. Ball home. Ball is given. Made the most of it, ball home there. Mechanic by trade. Ball home. Team has a first gear here with a goal. Great position. Any space to run up, doesn't have to cross the tape, so he's not going to stutter his run. Right foot shot. Oh, it goes that in. It looked like it was to me. We'll see in a second. Yes, it has been given. I'll tell you what, full on Kung Fu celebration there. Let's watch this again. Rattles in, yeah. Rattles. Little doubt in my mind it was in, I said straight away. Yeah, he touched the back of the net, so great strike, wasn't it? So much power. So France picked up where he left off yesterday. And it's some style, Lorenc now. He was a goal scorer yesterday. They need one from him quickly, or somebody else. Sadly for that Spain, that someone else isn't. Dries. What a strike that was from Belhomme. Power he got in that. Cameraman having a funny turn there. This is. To Dries. Oh, I need to be careful. The player's just taking a knock. Maybe not the idea to pass it to him. Dries. Such an energetic player there you see on the right hand side of your picture. Masquez doesn't actually live in France, does any French, what would you call it, overseas territory maybe, of Reunion. It's an island just below Madagascar. Must be kind of like someone from the Falkland Islands playing for England. Also, too much to say. Donner, simple problem with his teeth there. And Dupin, problem with his ears. Apart from that, we're all okay. So, here we go. Well, I'd say that was a good save. It was a spectacular save, shall we say, a bit Hollywood. He made sure, it's with a flourish. Squares. See why he wanted to shoot early there, but he's wrapped his foot around the ball. Yeah. A little bit more spectacular than it needed to be. He's got the bright kit, he's got the bright gloves. A flashy save to go with it. Donna. See there. Ball forward quickly, Dupin. He does do well around his box. Passes. Well. Taking the more unusual route of kicking it in rather than throwing it, as most players do. Oh, that was good, quick play by Barty. Two goals yesterday, couldn't add to it then. I tell you what, they're looking very, very sharp, France. They just picked up exactly where they left off yesterday. Confidence is always so important in beach soccer, any sport. If you've got confidence and belief, can give you an extra 10-20% in terms of performance. Antonio now goes wide. This. This is one-on-one. Has to cut inside. Maybe not the wisest thing to do at the moment when you're one-on-one. You lose that ball. Your opponent's in on goal. Falsos. To the goalkeeper, no risk need to be taken at this stage. Had away by the smaller of the two players there. Again, France going for the kick in. This is something they practiced in training. Bizzo just couldn't get on the end of it, but almost using it like a corner. I think they do fancy it in the air against Spain. This picks it up. Dupin a little casual there. We knew that was wide, it was just too quick. Andres, bright spot for Spain so far. It was a bright spot yesterday as well. I get the feeling, if you look at the French team, their forward line there. Danak is going to be a weapon they use with a high ball. Very small Spanish defence. Oh, that's a great save from Dupin. Brilliantly down to his right-hand side. Well, he maybe went a little bit spectacular on a previous save. That one, no. Didn't exaggerate that at all. Brilliantly down to his right-hand side. Strong right hand. Quick reflexes. Beat soccer, and there's so many goals. If you do have a good goalkeeper, it'll make all the difference. Fisher back, the captain, former Marseille player. 41 years of age now. Still looks pretty fit. Dupin. Now they're going for that higher ball again. Darak though looks around, says, "You've got to hit me." She decides to compare to the other players. You see why he's saying that. Darak thinks about closing. Spain, we expect just rotate it wide. So there's going to be an overhead, there is. Well, Dupin is either supremely confident, he just wasn't going to get to that. He's got to be careful though. Very, very loose on the edge of the box there. You've got to be careful. Okay, two teams who, Sun and Hotel, both sets of coaches looking at videos. Both deciding what works and what doesn't and what's the weaknesses of their opposition. And Spain obviously said, right, we press high. France have obviously said, we've got height forwards. We can use Darak, then get it forward quickly, get it forward high. He's up. Whoa, again, edge of the box. Could be, they're going to be found out here if they're not careful. Oh, Barty. Head across. Lucassi. There you've got Taylor two styles here. Barty is tall, not as tall as Darak. Well, they're both getting forward, hoping for the ball, waiting for the ball there. And then Spain there is pushing really high and pushing on these French defenders who haven't learned as yet. Playing around the edge of their box is a dangerous, dangerous game. They need to change that tactic quickly. Good bet. We'll not talk about that again, shall we? Look how high there. Spain up. Hassling, hurrying. Again, France go long. Cannot find Barbate. Fisher with the throw. She does well, but the referee sees it as a foul. He doesn't, obviously. Alonso. Sit there with the Red Bull, I think. Again, exactly the same spot for that free kick. Nowhere near the goal. Cheeky, with not a cheeky finish. Which is the standard line I have written down here for any time he scores a goal. Oh, what a good turn and shot by Barty. Jakobsen of Norway is the leading scorer across the tournament today. Across the tournament the last 2 days, I should say. Barty will be one of the few with a chance to catch him, having scored two yesterday. Says Donna knows where it's going. Another personal trainer. Most popular profession amongst beach soccer players. Squares, full of energy for France. No touch was a handball, or the second touch was his hand. He knows it. Alonso, hands on hips, not looking too happy. Donna doing the same as the last two free kicks. The only net he's hitting is the one behind the goal. The Hom muscled off the ball out. Donna goes forward quickly, straight to Dupe. Great play accepts. You'll see the high there, Spain, on says. A little bit risky. Jeremy Soares back to his goalkeeper. And the goalkeeper needs to move quickly. So we're set. A good chance for Spain. Last three kicks they've had been well over the bar. This one, however, is more central and closer. Rank is the man charged with taking it. Steps up, left foot strike. Oh, well, it's the touch, it's the bar, it's the sand that stops it going in the back of the net. Bell home. Easily done by Dupin. Well, it's a bit of everything there to save them. The other end. Donna gets the ball. He can play it forward quickly. Has had possession in the meantime. We've got a close up of Bell home. Antonio. Step by Dris. There's the way we had here. Jakobsen doing that. No way. Doesn't really have any effect in beach soccer because you fade one way, go the other. Because of the sand, you've not got really the ability to accelerate away quickly enough. Donna's out really strongly there. Neither player was pulling out there. Bizzo or Donna. Full blooded stuff there. Dris. To his goalkeeper. Out to the ring quickly. Right now. Bizzo opposite him. Looks for the shot. There is the shot. Good save by Dupin. He took a little deflection. Basque is there. Dris now. Let's get a crossover. Basque overhead click clearance. You don't see that too often in beach soccer. Two balls on the pitch. Hands are struggling to cope with one at the moment. Big throw to the far post. Good block. Good save. Solid, solid stuff from France. They are really tight here. You just wonder, can they keep this going for the entire 36 minutes? Energy sapping conditions out there. Good block again, Bizou. Sees the corner. Dupin. Bishop. Donna. Cuts inside, has the shot. Decent block there by Yannick. Sintas just probing on this Spain. Almost like they're full internationals, they just move the ball around until they find that gap. Rotating it right to left, this time it's left, tucks in. Oh, took a big, big bounce there. Dupin, I think he caught today, yesterday as well. We've seen some strange bounces. We should watch this again. It is very, very hard underneath what it. I'm sure they'll be kissing it more if it does manage to block a few of the Spanish shots and save him. Oh, there we go, France straight away. Well, they scored quickly in the first period, and they've done it again. And it's shell shock, really, for Spain. Jeremy Suarez with the goal, Gerard Sargent. One clap he gives his player there. It's kind of nervy, isn't it? Sometimes when you play these bigger teams and you score goals against them, it's almost like poking them with a, or poking a Rottweiler with a pointy stick. It's going to bite back at some point, but you've got to do it. Well, you don't have to poke a Rottweiler with a pointy stick, of course, but if you want to win in beach soccer, you have to score against bigger and better opponents and rile them a little bit. Antonio, shots wide. I don't know whether I should put a warning out there now to tell people not to poke a Rottweiler with a pointy stick. It's pretty obvious, isn't it? Antonio follows up his shot with the head out. Suarez has taken a knock there to his toe. He's going for the bench. Hopefully he's okay. His manicure's not ruined. Bizou watching on. Vasquez, are they coming on? No, Liv goes on. So a switching goal for Spain. Christian Mendes, policeman by trade. Gerard Sargent, calm presence on the France bench. Jeremy Suarez, good save. Reclining calmness here. It's a decent save, wasn't it? Christian Mendes doesn't get too much game time for Spain with dominant presence of Donna, former Golden Glove winner at the World Cup. He's been outstanding so far, Dupin, as are his teammates. I mean, fair home. Fair home, oh, that's a golden chance there. Swung his leg at it, took his eye off it and missed. Two goals in the field against this pretty talented Spanish team is not enough. Big shout there from Christian. Big shout, but not a big pair of hands holding onto the ball. Went for the catch, didn't he? But he ended up patting it out. Avenka, Jeremy Suarez. Keepers out well, Dupont. Go to the centre. Always does when it's an infringement rather than a straight out foul. We'll keep it going out to pick it up. What's the issue there? Shot and a finish. Well, Antonio strikes it home. A bit of relief they're back in Spain. We have to say France lowering the rules there. Silly things cost themselves. So the clean sheet is not on now for Dupin. Antonio, two goals in two games now. Goalkeeper Christian goes flatter with his throws than Donner. Let's pick it up. Bizou. Looked like it gone out, it didn't. He's crowded out. Two Spanish players on him. Pitching, he gets the free kick on the throw, in fact. Vasquez, space. He can get a shot away, he can't. There's some real needle in this game now, isn't it? Two teams battling. Dupin. The most deftest defender from Barbotti. That's great, no. Foul, well, that's a very, very late whistle there, isn't it? Gets the foul. Scray steps up, shoots, it's wide. Could have done, put a bit of pressure on Christian there. I'm pretty sure it's a match practice for Spain. Decent block by Yannick. The zoom mops up. Big cloud of sand over there. Pretty dry, as you can see. We need to do water to sand, haven't done today. Good touch and a good save. Well, can they keep it in, France? No. So it is the corner. Big left hand there, wasn't it, from Sintas's shot. This again on the volley, straight at him, but he had to watch it. Dupin, not the best there with his hands, but he gets away with it. Nobody near him in his Spanish shirt. Nick Fisher, former Marseille player, as I mentioned, now works in the building trade. Not out of the area from what I can see. He almost took panic there when everyone screamed. Oh, come on, got to be a foul right in front of the referee there. That's great. Grinning and nodding. Chris says nothing as he trudges off. Joachim Alonso. And it was being there, done it in the 11-a-side game in La Liga, Spanish national team, and beach soccer as well. Former Sporting Gijón, Spanish international. Shot straight to Christian, no one round him, a bit like Dupin before, so it means he can collect the rebound. Not particularly tidy goalkeeping. There's the overhead, over the bar. It's quite the intensity we saw in the first period here. They're still closing Spain quite a lot, but they're not it's quite as high as they were. Wow, sick, just inches away. Yannick Fischer does the turn, the shot. It's a deflection, doesn't it? Like it did, though not given. Tris takes the knock. Is he going to give the foul? Twist there, goes for the shot. Good block in the end. The old phrase is let the player know you're there. Good bat, one handed, casually done. Galhan. I think he flicked that without really knowing where somebody was. Barty. Christian may have come for that, he didn't in the end. I say it's nicely done. Well, it looked good for the photos, but no direction on it. Free kick. France can get that breather they need. Exactly halfway through the second period, halfway through the match. You get a feeling a goal is going to be nowhere near what you need. Get yourself a victory in this game. Goal difference is not going to win it for you unless you manage to score it with a minute or two left. See how dry the pitch is there. Very difficult conditions, pretty hard pitch. Picking up plenty of sand. Christian, ready. Low, ready to spring. Falcon, decent save. Solid hands. I just want to move this corner quickly. They do so. Go to the far post. They get the throw. Big show. Jeremy Suarez pleads his innocence. What? No. It's Edward. It's just a throw back. It's the word. Drop ball in the end. Two words. Suarez with the header. Nicely taken by Christian. Neat and tidy. Fajon. He's managed to score an own goal yesterday with a header. Even though we are 6 minutes left in this period, it's getting slightly desperate, isn't it, for some of France's defending. There's no calmness on the ball, and then in their own half, just inviting pressure from Spain. A flick from Jeremy Suarez. He's not matched in skill by the finish. So France organised themselves, that tight box formation. Two in front, two behind. Good strike, good save by Dupont. Quickly off his line to recover as well. That's our play. Christian. Is to stop criminals as a policeman. So today is to stop goals. It's an interesting flick there from Barbati. I'm not sure I knew too much about what it meant. All right, it's a good finish in the end though. And Spain back in the game. You can see by the reaction there. It's businesslike. We've got to get this done. Salvador Adriel, cheeky. Should we do the cheeky finish line? Lorenc made the goal, didn't he? The overhead kick, and just unmarked. He needed a player right next to him there. Cheeky. He wasn't. It's one of the rare times that France have laxed in their defensive duties. That's great. Sintas. That's great. That's great. So there's Pasquale. Doreng, good block. By Yannick, 41 years of age, belies his years though, fit looking player. There's all that professional experience behind him as well. On camera, on the camera woman. Dusts himself down. See, he takes the little nudge there from Barbati. Oh, well, yep, I would imagine she does feel quite hot in this weather. Lorenc takes his time. This could be the first time that Spain lead in this game. He puts it home. Big deep breath. Big left foot strike. And a good finish. Well, he saw from that angle perfectly. Dupin took a step to his left and that killed him. Lorenc side footed it home, but I got a feeling Dupin just stayed still, waited and waited. Then he might have got a hand to that. You'll see from that angle, but he did take that step, Dupin. There you go. Should have just held his position, really. Lorenc saw him take that step. But in the other corner, I mean, Spain lead for the first time. Spain at 3-2. Second period. Just over 3 minutes, 40 seconds left. That's great. Battles in the corner. Tough little player, him. Always full of energy for that France national team. Always tries his best. Always shows real commitment to the badge. Also shows the commitment of travelling for Reunion, an island just below Madagascar for all the even home games, which will be away for him. Away from Belholm. free kick given. In a penalty position. In essence, all free kicks realistically similar to penalties, they're unopposed. Straight to goal. Antonio scored two already in this tournament. Is it going to be three? No, it's not. But it is now. Well, Antonio didn't finish it. But in the end, Edward did. Edward Suarez. Only some daylight now between Spain and France. This is the scoreline by which Spain lost yesterday. Dupont did really well there, but Fisher just couldn't close quick enough. Edward has got a good two or three steps head start there, hasn't he? So France, what have they got in the tank here? So over shot overhead. Carrack. He can't get on the end of it. Shot over, there is the finish. And that man, Darak, straight away comes up with the answer. 4-3 now. As you can see from the spelling on his shirt, slightly different to what they've got on the caption. On my team sheet here, doesn't matter how you spell it. As he scores, nobody cares. Held his position there, a little flick from the Spanish defender and left foot strikes it home. Christian looks around and says, shouldn't one of you be here as well? Tintas, Antonio. And it goes wide, but Bajon gets in there. Winded there, Darak, I think. And a short breather. No sign of any medical staff as yet. Not sure what that date is on the shoulder. Look there, very, very hot here today, over 30 degrees. Time to tell you, beachsoccer.com, you can get all the match reports there, videos, some of the greatest goals in beach soccer. The top 10 are there, well worth checking out. Just Google beach soccer, we'll pop up at the top. You can follow us on our social as well. Watch some highlights here. Larenk with his finish. That's the goal of things. Closer than ever from Darak. 4-3 the scoreline. Spain 4, France 3. Oh, it looked absolutely nothing on Jeremy Suarez. Be too upset about having that ice pack on it. Bell on the way. The touch, well, Dupin tangled in the net. That's a decent save. Say, give me a chance, man. It's just down to the far post. Well, Barty goes forward, tries to find Bellholm. Combination of goalkeeper and defender stops him now. Forward by Christian. That was the right idea. Just a floated in the air a bit too long, so the header was defensive rather than attacking. Christian. Christian. Lejeune. Ambitious on that distance, really. Bizou closed down quickly. His France now have possession of the ball. Francaise de Dupont. A lot of players spend a lot of time on the pitch for France. Still very tired now. The home has been so energetic, chasing everything down. They're hunting in one, really, rather than two, as Spain have been in terms of closing down on the defence. Bizou now, third on goal. Oh, we think maybe he could have gone with the right foot and put it away. It's a wonderful thing. It was a decent save though from Christian. Christian, hands on the ball. Bizou, let me think. Is the left foot in there somewhere? Referee telling people what's what. Francais, calm down. Goal scorer Edwin Suarez as well, being told. So we get the free kick for France. It's going to be right in the centre of goal. We see Laurent. Goal scorer from yesterday, come on, and Yannick. With the rules of beach soccer, you can't make the mound, you put the ball on with your hands, you've got to use your feet and the ball in your hands, if you see what I mean. Same routine for Christian. Squats down, raises himself up a little bit. Bizou with the shot, the bounce, and ushered right. I'm sure he's ushered plenty of traffic in his time as a policeman, so he's adept at ushering that ball wide. Say strong hands by Dupont. Early strike and anger is wide. Running with it. Tintas we see there as we flash back to France getting a ball forward quickly. Bizou with the header. Not going to trouble Donner though. Goes again, far side. Headed to the middle. Well, that would almost be the classic beach soccer goal if that had happened. Cheeky just couldn't direct his shot to the end, but the wide ball, quick flat throw, the header, or the one touch across, and then the finish. Third part was missing then. Here we go again. Same that time, nobody arriving in the middle. And we've got to be careful here. This ball running, look how high it's playing and playing. They're just waiting for a little stumble or the ball to just move an inch or two further away from their foot. And that you'd be comfortable with, then they're in. Shot. Well held by Donna. So there's a bit of a knock in the first couple of minutes of the last period. It seems okay now, though. It's got a nice bit of pace to it, this final period, hasn't it? End to end at the moment. Oh, good good strike and a great finish in the end. Well, disappointing with Dupin. He won't care though. Loren Gomez restores that two-goal cushion for Spain. 5-3 now. Scored in each of his appearances here at this tournament. Feeling, didn't he, as that dropped and drifted in. He had the tools he needed to finish it off. Great left foot strike, wasn't it? Goalkeeper obviously going to ask questions of himself, but he hit the target and he got some pace behind it. You have to hope the rest of it takes care of itself, which it did. His ball forward, Yannick down, mops up, moves inside really well. He's 41 years of age there. Decent effort from Vasquez. Donner. Much more confident with his hands, isn't he, than Christian. Has solid, quick hands, holds onto the ball really well. You get the feeling, don't you, looking at him, the thing that may have stopped him making it in the pro game, loving the side game, is just his height. Go backwards. Donner. Donner again. Lovely touch from Varenk. They're slightly playing with France now. Spain. Just wide. Had to deal with it, cheeky. He's on the back of his shirt. Not sure the story behind that. A bit raggedy from France. Oh, he's in on goal, Antonio, and he just stumbled then. Ball got stuck in the sand. Well, sometimes it takes the bounce in your favour on the sand and gives you that little bit of luck. Sometimes it works against you. It was the latter then. Here's again Antonio's a nice ball into the middle. They're just picking an area rather than a player out. They're home. Ouch. Sintas. Nice as beach soccer from Spain. There's plenty of space in France. Might have gone in that way, a some team goal. And it stands still in touching distance for France. Bizot. He woke somebody up on a sun lounge behind the stand there. Donna. Nice beach soccer, just moving the ball really well. Unravels at the end though. Girls up at home, is there ready to swing. With two interceptions in a row from Sintas. In France, do not get in on that goal. Mutterings there, yeah, Sergeant. Not too much he can do now, he's just got to hope on the drive of his players. A little bit of skill and some luck. So wait, Spain going to take that free kick. Some of the coaches in beach soccer do. As well as working on the national teams, go off and work elsewhere, coach other players and other teams. Alonso in demand for that, the Spanish coach. Good block by Balholm. Hey! take by Donna Duzo with a show. Nothing given. Play forward. Nicely done. Just couldn't find that blue shirt though. He's got a nice looping throw, DuPont. I think Spain are getting wiser and wiser to it now. Pizu can't complain there. Paul Andres. See, both teams have their fair share. It's got to be the bounce in front of the keeper here to do the damage. Such a long way out. Lido Andres steps up, slowish run up. Not sure if he meant a shot or was trying to roll it through to his teammates. Either way, pretty hopeless. Done it. Push in the back. Carrick, or Danek, I should say, not Michael Carrick, the singer. He's definitely going to need to wash his hair tonight. He better knock all that sand off his shirt, he's going to clog the washing machine. So, Danek will take this free kick again. It's very similar to Driss's. It's a long way away. Driss kind of hooked his foot around the ball. It whimpered wide. He'd do a better job. Well, he can, but such good hands, hasn't he, Donnerst? Everything sticks. This. This holding on to the ball. Crazy. Saying, didn't touch him. He didn't touch him once. Touched him a whole six times, to be fair. Such a tenacious player. Frenchman. He kicks all once, twice, three times, four. Fifth, I'll go over. Just wearing him down. Donna now. Push it away. It's lost a lot of its shape this game. Spain quite happy to control the tempo, and they are doing well. That's poor defending. Squares can't control it, can't get through that gap. What do you mean about it being scrappy? Relaxing moment there for Donna as the ball goes nicely back into his hands. And well, that should have been a goal, it should have been a finish. It wasn't, and who'd you blame there? Cheeky, or just the pace of the ball? Gets that classic move wide, one touch across, and blame Cheeky. Squares, makes the foul again. Wholesale changes for Spain. There's much doubt here, needs to be careful. Squares though, he doesn't pick up a yellow. So Antonio Van Foul gets the free kick. He had one just before, around about 5 or 6 meters back from this one. well held by Dupont. One error, had a very good game today. So there's a, well, not quite sure what happened there. It's going to be a little bit more concentrated. Donner's out a long way. Commands his area. Fisher waits. Chests it back. Fell home. The overhead is on. So is the block as well from Cheeky. No home again. Fast running out of time now. France well under the 5 minute mark. Psychological lapse. Someone says you've got 5 minutes to do something. You feel like you've got a long time. So you've got 3 minutes. You do feel under pressure. Donna, Barbotti can't get there. Bellholm's charging through. And he mops up Donna in the end there. They should have been a little bit more alert there, Spain, I think. Overhead goes nowhere in particular. The foot, though, goes into the back of Hazard's head. And they're waving for the officials to get on. He wants them on. Once the game start again. There we go. Ouch. In the meantime, while you're watching those replays, ball's gone out on the far side. That's how it. Squeeze. Oh, that's a good effort, isn't it, with the outside of the right, and Donna was sharp to it. Squeeze is in the middle. Not going to reach him now. Well, we need something serious to happen for France. We need it to happen soon. That's great. There's France. Realistically limping towards the defeat here, and he's so disappointed after their performance yesterday. What it does do is open up for the group. We had Russia losing yesterday. They were beaten by a lesser opposition, as was Spain. France beating Russia, Spain beaten by Germany. Depending on results today, could all be on the final day with a number of different teams ready for victory. Sometimes in the Euro Beach Soccer League, we get teams done and dusted and winners by the second day. Don't think that's going to happen today. So a knock on the neck. One France player with a kick to the back of the neck. So, D cut it out. Spanish player taking a knock to the front of his neck. As it is though, it is a France free kick. From such a distance, it's got to be very special to beat Donna. There's the shots. Oh, bobbled horribly in front of Donner there, just scoops it away. Flag down, man down. Spain. Any ascendancy on shots, any ascendancy on goals. Of course, is the most important stat. Let's go then. got to score now, France. Well, we had the game before, and Norway got within one goal with 24 seconds left, and then somehow managed to lose by the two. Overhead, Bahon. Oh, there is the finish. Well, it is definitely 100% game on for the final minute here. 57 seconds on the clock. Bahon has scored. He is now Spain 5, France 4. Just a lovely flick up, wasn't it? He had time, he had space. He dipped in behind the Spanish defence. Sitas had left him. It's a good, good finish, Darak, making sure. So, if it is a draw at the end of regulation time, we go to penalties. So overtime, I should say, 3 minutes and then penalties. Spain could have done with just easing the pressure there with a goal. As it is, France have possession now. Plenty of time to score. Spain now one-on-one, two-on-two at the other end. Good clearance. That's who Sales hang on, but they need those seconds. Donna. Another knock there, painfully on the shin, shin to shin, Antonio. Marbotti. The result is free kick to Spain. We're just a goal ahead and 10 seconds on the clock. You'd almost want to play this one as slowly as possible. He's let it just roll towards the goalkeeper, waste 3 seconds, surely. I'm sure it'll be a shot on goal. It will close things up, it went in. I think the main thing is to not allow the keeper to hold on to this one. That's the key. There's the shot, and he has held on to it. Are we going to get a bit of drama in the last few seconds? 6 seconds left. Suarez looking for the gap, looking for the gap, can't find it. Surrounded by Spanish players, and that is it.